Hey, this is your girl Cherie and
Laverne,
and we back with Get Your Tea with LSP. We missing our P for a little bit, but she'll be in shortly. Today we're going to let y'all know about facts about domestic violence, symptoms of HIV, myths about STDs, 7 characteristics of why men cheat, and 10 reasons men cheat. I'm sorry, 7 characteristics of a cheating man, and then the 10 reasons why men cheat. What's up with you today, Laverne?
Oh, nothing. Just chilling. Just trying to figure some things out. What's going on? How was your weekend?
It was decent. It was good. We went down to the Taste of Omaha on Friday. Then we relaxed on Saturday, and we relaxed on Sunday. Went to church, came home, and did some more relaxing.
I didn't do nothing. I just went shopping this weekend. You know, I got to stay out of the mall. I just been shopping and, you know, just chilling.
Lady has to keep herself up.
Yeah, you're right.
Okay, y'all. Well, we're going to get right into some of our topics then. Let's start talking about domestic violence. Right now, I want to give Nikki Eubanks a shout out. Rest in heaven. You was precious to a lot of people. You went up my news feed so many different times. My husband knew you well. I didn't know you, but my husband knew you well. And I mean, he shed real tears over your death. So I know you had to be very, very special to a lot of people in the community. Did you know her?
Yeah, I did.
You did? Yeah. Oh, okay. So, you got anything to say?
Yeah, I mean, it's just a sad situation. I mean, you know, Smalls, that's my bro. I love him so much. So I know he was really going through it. He was really, you know, this is a difficult time for him and also his family. So I just want to let everybody know that, you know, they're in my prayers. And, Kia, I feel so bad. That's a horrible thing.
So I think domestic violence is a problem in our community. I think a lot of us just really don't take domestic violence serious. Once a man put his hands on you, why is it that we don't walk away? Is it that we are, our self-esteem is too low, or is it love why you don't walk away?
Well, you know what? I mean, I've been in that situation. You know, I was in, you know, my marriage was very, 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 I mean, it was horrible. And, you know, it's some good days, you know, and then it was some bad days. But when you feel like that you have to walk around your own house on eggshells and thinking that, you know, if you do something wrong, if you say something wrong, then, you know, your spouse or your baby daddy, your husband, your boyfriend, whatever, is going to put their hands on you, then that means you need to leave that relationship. I mean, I really stayed. I really thought that, you know, things could work out, that he wasn't going to do it again. I mean, 2 weeks later, it was the same thing. So, you know, enough is enough. You know, I think that, and I don't think it has to do with you having low self-esteem, because I know I really have over the top self-esteem. So, I mean, I don't think that's it. I think that you want it to work so bad that, you know, you stay and you think that they're going to change, but in all actuality, it's not going to change. So
I've never been in a domestic violence relationship, but I grew up in a household where I seen my mom go through years and years of domestic violence. And I just never could figure out for the life of me why she would stay with, you know, the man that she was with, you know, but she just never walked away.
Well, you know what? And that's another thing that I want to say. Like, I think that my kids, you know, they didn't actually see all the physical going on, but just because your kids is not in the room don't mean that they don't know what's going on. Kids know what's going on. Whenever you get through, they know what's going on. So, you know, it was times when my kids would come, you know, running in the room like, you know, mom, is you okay? Are you okay? My mom, you know, coming to my house, they didn't got on the phone and called my mom. So, you know, Betty Jean ain't no joke. Betty coming. Mm-hmm. So next thing I know, my mom at the door, like, what's going on? You know, so, you know, and then when you give your family, you know, they'll get involved because they like, no, he don't have no business putting his hands on you. Mm-hmm. But then when you get your family involved, that could end up really deadly. A bad thing can happen. And then what's going to happen? You right back with the dude. You know what I'm saying? I mean, it's just a bad situation all the way around. I know right now, though, where I'm at in my life now, I wish somebody would. You know what I'm saying? Ain't nothing. I would never tolerate nothing like that ever in my life. If I see a sign of he can be abusive. I'm out of there.
I think a lot of women don't leave too because they think that they're scared. There's maybe the man is taking care of them. They're scared to get out here and they don't think they're going to be able to find a job. The man could be telling them, if you leave me, I'll kill you, you know? So they could be scared for their lives or anything. You know, we never know why the woman don't leave.
I mean, it's a variety of different reasons why a woman don't leave. We'll never know, you know, why. But, you know, at the end of the day, you got to love yourself, because I had to say, at first, I think I stayed because I didn't want people to be like, oh, you know, her marriage failed again. You know how people are. Oh, her marriage failed again. All this and that. I think I stayed for the wrong reasons because of what everybody else was going to think. But then after, I was like, man, I got to, you know, this dude is going to end up killing me, seriously. And so, you know, I left, and, you know, I got a divorce, and it's all good now.
And a lot of people out there think that domestic violence only happens to women of color or poor women. Domestic violence happens to women of every race, religion, creed, no matter your class, your status, whatever. Oh, domestic definitely. Violence happens to everybody.
Because I was going to the YWCA, and I was taking, you know, because I felt like, you know, I needed to find out what was going on. Why would I stay in this marriage? And I needed to get out. So I had started attending these women groups. And it was doctors in there. I mean, it was women that was doctors. It was wives of police officers that was in there, that their husbands was beating on them. I mean, it was a variety of different people. So it just does not just happen with, you know, low class people are, I mean, it's a sad situation.
So ladies, domestic violence can happen to you of any class, culture, religion, sexual orientation, marital status, your age. It just doesn't matter. If you're in a domestic violence relationship, get out of it.
But no, let me tell you this. This ain't funny, but it's true. I know a man, and this is not funny. This woman was beating her. See why I knew you was gonna laugh. I'm serious, girl. This is serious.
It's not funny.
It is men that get beat and abused by women. And the men, I mean, I don't know what type of men these is that or where they find these men at, but they have been abused. And it just does not start. It's just not women. Men that's beating on women. It's women that's beating on men and abusing them. And I know one dude right now. I'm serious. He is a nice looking dude, and I couldn't believe it when he told me that his girlfriend just used to haul out and just bust him in the head and stuff like that. I was in shock because I never knew that it existed with men.
Right. And I think the thing about it too is that women fight men fight women, and I don't think that they really think that they in a domestic violence situation, you know, until something bad happens. I think that they kind of think it's kind of cute, you know? Oh, he put his hands on me, he loved me.
No. Well, that ain't.
She beat me up. She loved me.
That's not love. I'm serious.
Because so nobody deserves to be hit, right?
Right. Girl, when I had black eyes and stuff, girl, that was devastating. You know what I'm saying? How do you explain that to your family? You couldn't go around your family and stuff for weeks at a time because, you know, they knew. But people know what's going on. Some people know what's going on.
Now, when you was in your situation, was he on drugs or alcohol? Was any of those factors? Because I think a lot of those is factors in, you know, why men or women do hit, you know, the other person.
Oh, yeah, definitely. I mean, you know, and then the sad part about it is when you with somebody, that's why you don't go rushing into marriage and stuff, you know, because I married my last husband not knowing that he was on drugs. I didn't even know. I didn't find out until 2 years later. I didn't know.
Wow.
And so, you know, popping pills, doing all that, I did not know. So when you go into rushing into something with people, you need to know who you laying with. Seriously.
Well, I'm going to tell y'all about 1 in 3 American women have been physically abused by their husband or boyfriend at some point in time in their life. So if one of y'all out there is getting abused, get away from that man or woman. Love yourself enough, love your kids enough, and walk away. Just walk away. Because right now, some family has buried one of their loved ones from years, and they said she was in years and years of domestic violence, in years and years of domestic violence with her husband. He was her husband, and he finally killed her. Yeah, and that's sad. So we got to get it together. We got to stop putting our hands on each other. Well, I never put my hands on my husband, but and he never puts his on me. And I'm just thankful for that.
Yes, that's good, because that's not a good thing at all. So moving right along.
What do you got for us, Laverne?
I guess we're going to talk about STDs.
Okay.
So, hey, you know all them people around. I hate to say it, but it's true. We got some nasty folks running around here. They are just, it's just sickening. I mean.
We do.
It's sickening. And then, you know, they don't believe in going to get checkups and and all of that. You know, and then, you know, the females, y'all, I know y'all got Medicaid. You know, a lot of y'all got Medicaid, so I don't understand why you don't go to the doctor and get checked up. You know, I done smelled a couple of these females, and I know, I'm like, okay, if I smell you, I know you smell you.
Yeah.
You know what I'm
saying? And that's one of the myths about STDs is that you'll see it. People think that if I got an STD, I'll see it, I'll know it, you know, I got an STD. No, STDs are silent. You can have an STD in your body and not know it at all. Mm-hmm. You need to go get checked out at least every 6 months to a year to find out if your body functions is working normal.
And you know what? If you are having multiple partners, which a lot of you guys are out there, you really need to be going to get checked. And see, that's another thing. They just don't think fat meat is greasy.
They
just
don't.
Running around here, just sleeping around with people. Now, I'm, you know, like I said, I keep the 100. Now, back in my younger days, you know, yeah, I had this dude, that dude. You know, I kicked it. But now, oh, you can't pay me. You can't pay me to lay with none of them out there. They are disgusting. Every man I see, I'm serious. As far as I'm concerned, they got HIV to me.
Yeah.
Every single
one. And that's
one,
how you're supposed to treat them.
Every single one. I don't care how fine you look, whatever. I'm not doing nothing with you. And you know what? I'm going to keep it that way. Because, see, when you go to playing with stuff like that, it's just not a good thing.
Right. And a lot of younger women, I'm going to say like teenagers, younger women that's out here having sex, they think that you can't get STDs from having oral sex, you know. And it's been proven that if he ejaculate in your mouth and you got a mouth sore or anything, you can get whatever he has. If he got HIV, if he got syphilis, if he got hepatitis B or hepatitis C, that's in your mouth. You got it.
Yeah,
it went through your open wound. So y'all need to start thinking before y'all just start going down on, you know, these young boys out here. You need to think about what he has. You need to start using some Saran wrap or something. Doctors don't recommend dental dam, but if you know you want to use that Saran wrap, that's more safer than dental dam. But use something.
Girl, I'm not using nothing. I don't want nothing. Let me tell you one thing. I don't want nothing. And that's another thing. And if he don't want to go get no test or whatever, you know, because like I've said several times before, I'm happy that I'm celibate. I am happy and I'm going to remain that way. And so therefore, you know, if a person that you are interested in having sex with, like I was, you know, like, dang, okay, you know, and I told him, look, go get the test, you know, and then, you know, maybe we might go further or whatever. He never went and got the test, so guess what? Ain't nothing. And I'm happy that I didn't do that. You know what I'm saying? Because things ain't even cool with us now. So, therefore, you know, it's just like you need to protect yourself. Period, point blank, bottom line.
Mm-hmm. And as far as the herpes, you can get herpes without the person having an outbreak. So don't think that just because you don't see the herpes on the body that you can't get herpes, because you can get herpes without the person, you know, showing any signs of sores or anything like that.
I mean, this is just making my skin crawl just thinking about this. I mean, seriously, because you know what? Do you know how many, you know, chances and that people take every day for a thrill that's going to only last you 10, 15, 20 minutes and your life could be, you know, just gone? I mean, you know what I'm saying? I don't even think that people really, really just realize how real that is. And
Well, you know what? Another myth is that only slutty girls or only nasty girls get STDs, which is not the case because classy, smart, cute, sexy, funny, they get STDs too. Everybody's body bleed the same way and do the same functions. You can get anything can enter your body, whether you pretty or what. It can enter your body. So don't think just because you're pretty with long hair and all the men want you that you safe and you protected because you're not, honey.
With a big booty and all that, that right. Them be the booty.
Exactly. So, don't let that booty get you in trouble.
Exactly. So, you know, you just really got to be careful and you got to just look out for yourself because I'm telling you, it's plenty of people right now that wish that they would have, you know, strapped up.
Yeah. Seriously. Oh, yes.
They wish they would have. That's why, I mean, I'm serious. It's by the grace of God. I thank you, Jesus, because I'm serious. That's scary.
If you don't got a condom, y'all know y'all can use plastic wrap. Use something. Go in that kitchen and get you some plastic wrap. I mean, it's really not recommended, but that is one of the ways. You can Google it and look it up. That's one of the ways to protect yourself from STDs. It's plastic wrap. So if y'all run out of condoms, nobody feels like going to the store in the middle of the night, get in that kitchen and get you some plastic wrap.
Oh, and then another thing. You know how females be like, well, as long as he coming home to me,
yeah.
Hold up. Now you sound like a fool because guess what? If you know that he out there doing that or you know that he's sleeping with this person and that person and you still allow him to come in there and lay up with you, girl, you don't know what you getting yourself into. That's what I'm saying. It has been proven. I was reading this story one time. And matter of fact, it's a book on the DL. And I was reading that book. And in the book, the woman was saying how she had been a virgin.
Mm-hmm.
And she had been with her, you know, husband. And that was the only person that she had ever been with.
Mm-hmm.
And she went to the doctor and found out that she had HIV. And she's like, you know, I've only been with my husband.
Mm-hmm.
Come to find out the husband was on the DL and brought that woman HIV. Now, that don't mean that it has to be a man that's on the DL. He could be just sleeping with multiple women mm-hmm. and bring you that. You know, you could be at home being faithful, being a good woman, being a good wife, whatever. And if your man is out there doing whatever in the streets, then, and it's a possibility that you can have something.
Yeah, exactly.
So, y'all need to be careful about that as well.
Don't go off of looks because the prettiest person, like I said before, can have the worstest things. And a lot of men, I'm going to say men, really tend to go off of looks. They see this fine woman. They see this banging shape, this big old booty and this little old waist. And you don't know what she got creepy crawling up her drawers.
Exactly. That is
you can't
true,
tell if a person got an STD. I'm going to tell you that right now. Because people do. They be like, oh, she look good or whatnot. You know, everything that look good
ain't
good for you. Like my grandma used to say, everything that glitters ain't gold.
For real.
That's an old saying, and I'm going to keep on using it.
That's real.
So, and the pill does not prevent STDs, little ones. I know that y'all think, because I went and got the pill, that it prevents STDs. No, it does not. That prevents babies. That prevents you from getting pregnant, but does not prevent you from getting gonorrhea, chlamydia, HIV, syphilis, and hepatitis. No, it doesn't. And then a lot of people, they think, you know, I got gonorrhea, I got chlamydia, that's treatable, you know, I'm good. No, you don't want to keep on getting those type of infections in your body because sooner or later your reproductive system shuts down and you won't be able to have kids. You'll have all kinds of scarring on your body and your ovaries and tubes and things, and you will not be able to have kids, period, point blank. And you might have to get a hysterectomy or anything. You don't want that to be happening to you, like, because you're thinking, well, I got this gonorrhea from him, you know, I went and got it treated, but you go back and sleep with him even though you know he still has it and didn't go get it treated. Well, I'm just go back and get mine treated. No, honey, you're gonna mess your body up doing that.
And then you know, and that's why a lot of people, like, you know, you see chicks like our age or whatever that don't have kids.
Mm-hmm.
That's one of the, I bet you that's why.
I bet it is too.
Because you ain't just not had no, I mean, seriously, I know some girls right now to this day ain't got not one kid. You know, that's because they body, they didn't have so many diseases and stuff. And, you know, it ain't right up in there.
STDs lead to infertility.
Yeah. So that I bet you that's what happened.
Mm-hmm. I bet you it's what happened too.
Dang, that's sad.
And some of y'all think that using two condoms is better than one. That is a myth. You think so, but the STD warns against using two condoms. It's all about frictions. The condoms rubbing against each other, the easy to break. Both condoms are more easy to break or slip off. So one condom is good enough. But however you do it, protect yourself, protect your life, value your life. I
recommend none at all. That's not even being realistic, because I guess some people just like, you know, that's really not being realistic when they say, you know, to be celibate, but it is. I mean, I know a lot of women. I didn't realize how many women that it is right now that's celibate. I mean, I know some that's been celibate for 2 years, 3 years, you know, that, and young girls. I mean, I'm not going to say young, but like in their 30s, early 30s. And, you know, that's a good thing. If a woman can hold on to that, and these men should take heed to that.
Yeah.
If that woman is not giving it up to you, and, you know, she like, hold up. That you know, that's saying something.
Yeah, before I met my husband, I went 19 months with no sex. I was celibate for 19 months, and I gladly told him, you know, when I met him, that I had been celibate for 19 months, but I was ready to go. Right. And, I mean, he's my husband today.
Right, so that's so, what's up. Yeah. Y'all married, and, you mm-hmm. know, things turned out good, so that's a good thing. I'm mm-hmm. hoping that happened in my situation, but
I'm hoping it does, too. Mm-hmm.
You already know.
Okay, you want to jump in the symptoms of the HIV, the old package?
You can.
Okay, well, we're going to start off with HIV and the symptoms of it. You can have abdominal cramps, nausea, vomiting, diarrhea, enlarged lymph nodes in your neck, your armpits, your groin, fever. Fever is very common. Headaches. Muscle aches and joint pain, skin rash, sore throat, weight loss. If you having any of these symptoms, no matter how mild to severe you're having, if you're having them, you need to go get checked for HIV.
But you know what? A lot of people in our culture, here come Precious. A lot of people in our culture, they are scared to go and get tested.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know why, but if I had something, I would want to try to, you know,
get some
medicine to get it. I mean, something. I just would know. Here's Precious, you guys. But that's what I would want to do. I would want. We talking about HIV. Symptoms.
And you know what? The earlier you get tested, the better prevention. I mean, the better they'll be able to get you on drugs.
Right.
Your life, you'll have longer span to your life the earlier you get tested.
They probably just thinking, I'm gonna die anyway.
Right. I'd rather die and not know if I got something.
Right. And then your health is fading and then you looking sick and everything. I see a lot of people right now. I see them and they look sick. They look bad. Mm-hmm. And I'll be saying to myself, ooh, they look bad. They probably got it. That's the first thing that I'm saying
but
to myself.
But it may take years for HIV symptoms to develop and stuff, you know. And then for AIDS to develop, it take like over 10 years. Yeah. So if you got HIV, you run in, you get your test, you find out, you get your medicines, you might not ever develop AIDS. I mean, you got better chances on that.
You'll always have it. What do you mean, like, if you...
No, you might not develop AIDS. You might have HIV, but you might not develop AIDS. Right, yeah, develop AIDS, because AIDS and HIV is two different things, basically. Right. So, if you get tested early enough, you have a chance.
Right.
You don't get tested early enough, once you get that AIDS, you out of here.
They just want to die.
Yeah.
Seriously, and some people, that's what I'm saying with our culture, they don't like to go and get tested. I don't know if it's just that they just scared, that, you know, of finding out, if that's the case. But, I mean, I was like, hey, you know, it is what it is.
I think people are so... people are not so concerned with their health nowadays. It's like, it's like, why are you scared to go? No. I mean, but then it's like, if you know that you've been sleeping around with so many people, they fail to realize you sleep around with somebody unprotected. That person may have slept around with somebody.
Right.
And then you don't know how many people that person slept around. So really, truly, you can sleep with one person.
Yeah.
And you really can be sleeping with 200 people.
Yeah. Yeah. Exactly.
It's like a chain reaction. And I mean, I think people need to really start caring about what's going on with their bodies, because we got some high STD rates in
Girl,
Omaha.
Girl, it's yes.
Yeah.
It's bad.
I did an HIV conference. I've done one every year for the past 3 to 4 years with Girls Inc. And I'll never forget, there was a story. The one girl that came this past year, she was telling a story about how her parents basically, they were married. They were living in the house together. You know, everybody was, it was all cool. Her dad gave her mom AIDS. Uh-huh. Her mom died. Her dad died. And then, like, a year later, her mom died.
Laverne was just talking about, you know, something like that.
Like, orphans. And then yeah. The family didn't want to take the kids. So just think about that. If you're out here having unprotected sex, you risk the chance of leaving this earth. And if you have kids, who want to take care of people's kids nowadays? It's, I mean, I'm not to be so, like, heartless or anything, but people got their own kids they're trying to take care of.
Exactly.
So families that you got to realize, when you leave this world, who's going to be there to take care of your child?
And then not only that, okay, say you got HIV and you have a baby that has HIV, nobody's going to want to take care of your baby, especially if they know your baby has HIV. They're going to be like, people in this society is just like scared of it, you know? They're not going to want to do that. It's going to be hard to find somebody.
It's really not fair to bring a child into this world, especially when you know you have HIV.
Well, you know what?
You can do, and now there is people that are married, so not everybody get, not all children get it. Now let's get
right. Yeah, that's what I was just about to say. That's not all people don't get.
Yeah, you just take a risk.
But see, that's why it's important for you to get tested, because if you do have it and you are pregnant, mm-hmm. then you know you can probably possibly prevent your baby from coming into this world having to deal with that.
Yeah.
So, I mean, come on, y'all. Get it together, because I'm not touching none of y'all.
I got my test 2 months ago. First, I had my test when, you know, I got pregnant with my daughter.
Yeah.
And then I got signed up for some more insurance when me and my husband got married. You know, we had to get our insurance squared away. So, we had to get tested again. So, I know I got a clean bill.
And I'm happy. And no, seriously, I got a clean bill. And usually when it's 6 months, you should, if you are sleeping with somebody, anybody, mm-hmm. and your husband's nowadays, you got to go.
Anybody.
You need to go and get tested every 6 months. Now, I just got tested, what was that, a month ago?
About
a month and a half. Mm-hmm. Yeah, about a month and a half ago. Mm-hmm. And, you know, I got tested. I don't need to go get tested another 6 months, because I just got tested.
I go once a year, and that's because I am not in my relationship. I'm not having unprotected sex regards to me being in a relationship.
Okay.
That's just point blank. Anybody want to ask a question? Yes, we do. We use protection. I'm so sorry. We're not ready for that yet. And mm-hmm. that's something that, you know, I think that I respect from him. He respects from me. I have my test done every year around my birthday. I go, when I get my pap done, I get my test done.
Okay.
Yeah,
you need to get
a birthday present to
yourself for real, and that's a good birthday present.
I'm gonna be alive to see you next birthday.
Exactly, I feel.
And you need to get that pap done every year too.
Yes.
That pap is very important.
And all them fluids and stuff when you sleeping with. Now just think, people sleeping with different people with different fluids and stuff. Girl, I can't even take it.
Nasty. Nobody walks in talking about I'm running around like a drippy faucet.
Well, we gonna go ahead and take a break and leave y'all with some music so we can regroup, and we'll be back. Keep listening to 1690 AM.
I'm so horny, I just had it, still I want it, right up on it, whenever you come around. Then I can't stop thinking what I'm gonna do, as soon as I set these eyes on you.
Hello, hey, we're back.
I told you.
Okay. We are back. Our next topic is going to be 7 characteristics of men that cheat. Now, this should be a good one. So, Mr. Reed found us the 7 main topics why men cheat. So, let's go ahead and let's bring them out.
Okay, I guess he always has an excuse for everything, and he delivers these lines as if he has practiced them in the mirror.
Baby, you know I love you. Yeah.
It wasn't me. She's lying.
That wasn't my phone ringing like that.
Pitiful. And all of your dates and other activities are planned around his schedule.
Yes, when men cheat, they do that often. Like, you suggest, let's go to the movie, or let's go do this, and he suggests, well, no, let's go bowling, or let's go to this secluded spot over here in Bellevue or something, you know. Yeah. They always want to go to Bellevue, Council Bluffs, you know, outside secluded places.
Well, that means they hiding something.
Yeah, that's characteristic of a cheating man.
Like, I don't like that.
I mean, I can say. We go everywhere, and I'm sorry, I'm Inspector Gadget. I'm like, look here, I don't even like Village Point. Now, if we're not going out there to the Coach store, to the Apple store, there's no need, or Kona Grill, ain't no need for me coming out here.
If he can't take you right in the heart of Omaha, right dead in the center, right down 30th and Ames, right down.
This is the number one thing you know, cheating. If he don't take you to the Funny Bone. Because you know everybody be at the Funny Bone.
Man, let me tell you something.
You can't drive down 72nd.
I don't want to go down 30th.
Okay, anyway. I just said 72nd. If you can't drive down 72nd.
Well, I mean, just anything.
Or Ames. Period.
Females know. You know what I'm saying? And especially if you didn't already heard. This is Omaha. So you know if somebody that met. Because you know all you got to do is ask a question. You know what I'm saying? And people know who is. So, so you go find out. He used to mess with such and such. Or he messed with such and such. Yeah. So then you go find out. But it's some of y'all dudes that's so sneaky. Ooh, y'all so sneaky.
They tell you what you want to hear.
Girl be talking about they ain't got no woman. They by themselves. And you know, they sleeping with their dog, and that's it. And, you know, all this type of stuff. Don't nobody got time for that. You know you ain't sleeping with your dog.
Exactly.
What's the dog name?
Exactly. Hold on, they always say, I fell asleep. Hold on, if you say, right.
I want to know the dog's name.
D-O-G.
No, what's the dog name?
I'm not telling you that.
What's the dog name?
Hold on.
Green, yellow, orange, blue.
But one of their favorite excuses is if you text at night, they say they don't text you back that night. When y'all wake up the next day, oh, I fell asleep.
Right. That's their first thing.
That's the best excuse.
That's their first thing. They fell asleep. Now, you know you ain't fell asleep. And especially when you just text me. This is another
thing. So what do y'all do? What do y'all do if that happens to you? Now, and I'm going to tell you. Now, I'm going to ask this question. And I want everybody to be honest and tell me if they've done it. So if somebody texts you, you know it's like out of the ordinary. You be like, hold up. Do a drive by. Let me go see.
That's stalking.
No, see, and that's what I want to talk about, but Laverne don't ever want to talk about stalking.
Well, we can do that topic next week.
No, that's what I thought.
We could do it next week.
Listen, freedom of speech.
That's what I say. Whatever. I say same thing, Precious. We on the same.
But yeah, so then we got the number 3. He tells you everything you want to hear. And it says, okay, some guys who do not cheat will do this too, especially the needy ones who do not want you to want to lose you. However, a cheating guy is going to do everything he can to make you think he's completely devoted to you when they are very opposite.
When it's the very opposite.
It's like, why hold on to me? Dude, if you don't want to be with me, go.
If you don't want nothing to do with me, go. I mean, that's the whole thing. I think they waste people's time. Mm-hmm. Don't waste my time. Back. Go on about your business. You know what I'm saying? But then you got to, if you keep getting stood up and a person keeps telling you, oh, we go do this, we go do that. Well, hey, after a while, I'm like, hey, I'm telling you, I be sending some hate texts, too. They be bad. So, you know, I'm just like, hey, I'm done with this situation.
Yeah, because people, you can't play with, men have to realize, I mean, this is women, too, so, I mean, don't take this wrong thing. We're trying to bash the guys, but, you know, hey, women do it, too, but that'll be next week. But men, right about now, we're talking about you. You guys, they really kind of, they like to play with people's emotions. Yes. Women emotions.
Yes.
And look here, I don't got time for no, especially at my age, be playing with my emotions.
Exactly.
I'm dang near 40 in 6 years. But again, I don't have time for you to be playing with my emotions. Mm-mm. Talking about we going to go here. Oh, baby, I'm going to take you to dinner. We going to spend time on Saturday. We going to do this. And right. Then you ain't nowhere to be found. You like Casper the Ghost.
Right.
Can't even call, don't even know. And then, you know, I'll be like, I ain't going to tell. Somehow I'll be like, you know what? I hope he okay. But then I'll be like, you know what? Forget you. I don't care if you ran off with the dang JFK.
But you
sitting
know
in
what?
Sitting in somebody's train station. I don't care.
That go to show you that right there, that if they doing that in the beginning,
they going to continue.
Mm-hmm. They go, it's going to get worse because what? They go get comfortable with you.
Yep.
And they go say, oh, yeah, this is what she been accepting. You know what I mean?
And will you allow them to do it?
It's going
to
be a bad situation. So that's a red flag right there. Mm-hmm. So I mean, get away.
And a lot of them do that too to boost their ego because they want to feel like they this, they that, and the other, you know, and they attention seekers as well. So if they can call you at 2-3 o'clock in the morning and, you know, say, hey, what you doing and get some response back, you know, that's good for them.
Yeah.
But then the next day, you know, they don't want to be bothered. They like, no, oh, I was just texting her because I was bored.
Yeah, and it's not right. It's just not right.
And it's, and you know, and that's playing with people's emotions. And I just think that it's wrong. And especially when a person is kind of like delicate, like, you know, right, like right now, my situation is, you know, I'm by myself and, you know, it's been a while. And for a person to just continuously tell you, I'm going to do this, you know, we go do this, and then they don't follow through. Mm-hmm. And especially when I'm not interested in nobody but that one person, I mean, that just right there is just, like, devastating. So, you know, I had to just step back and just be like, you know, let me get focused back on, you know, what I need to be focused on. And so, you know, that part is history now. So back to focusing.
And that's cool. I mean, that's good because you just don't want to – it's like you put that so much time into that one person. That person not giving you the same amount of time,
right?
And the input, it's like, dang, you know. So, it is what it is. And then on number four, we have he never turns off his cell phone and he's always getting calls. They're always supposedly very important and he has to take them. While on the phone, he refers to you as a friend and says that he's not really doing anything instead of saying he's on a date with you. Now, let me tell you something. My guy never did no mess like that.
That's the indication. He's telling you straight up.
Number one, he's telling you straight up. Oh, exactly. I'm with a friend. No. Number one, if you on a date, and this goes for men and women, you need to turn your phone on silent. Right. I don't care.
Right.
That's just out of respect, you know. Me, I do check my phone every now and then because I think my daughter's going to call me. But as for me, like, answering the phone for somebody,
right.
If it's not my daughter or my sister or something, and if they call repeatedly, then I'll answer, you know. But no, I turn my phone off because that's just a sign of respect.
But that's coming from like a D-boy perspective. You know, D-boys is always, phone is always going off. They always got to answer their phone. Doughboy. Doughboy. A doughboy. He hustles. He's out here in the street. He's slanging. You know, he's making money from the streets.
We don't want those kind, though.
But that's the perspective that they try to treat you. Because I've been in relationships with them types of dude. I don't want that kind of dude no more. But I've been in a relationship with that kind of dude, you know. And I have accepted that where he like, oh, I got to go take this call. Hold on. This is such and such, you know, calling me. I got to go take this call or whatnot, you know. Yeah. So that's coming from that perspective when he does that. Now, right now, if I'm on a date with a man or if I'm on a date with my husband and he keep on telling me I got to go take this call, it's like, hold on. Either you're going to have to turn that phone off or you know, this date is done. And I'm going to be questioning, why do you keep on getting up to go take phone calls when we on a date?
But some dudes is smarter than that, though. I mean, if you that dumb, I mean, I would think that they would turn their phone off at least. You know what I'm saying?
Or put it on silent.
Okay, well, what about when he gets a call from his from somebody and he says, oh, this is my mother. I need to take this call and walks off. Because a man should be able to talk to his mother in front of you, right?
Oh, yeah, definitely.
So that's definitely a sign that he's cheating. And then he does not introduce you to his friends. This might be that he already has a girlfriend and his friends already know the girlfriend.
Well, you know, I don't know. I don't agree with that because I'm going to tell you something. These men nowadays, they'll take you one day, another one the next day around their friends.
They what Mama D say? Right. They say, the side chick know the mama too.
Right. Exactly.
The main chick.
So that ain't, I don't know.
Well, some men is more respectful than other men.
But then there's some men that know their friends, and some men don't introduce you to their male friends because they know that if that male see you out, he might try to holler at you. So they know which ones to introduce you to.
Exactly. Because, okay, like husbands that cheat, they know there's some people that they can introduce the sideline to, but there's some people that the wife is like totally 100% cool with, and he wouldn't dare take her around them.
That's true.
So that's that perspective.
Well, he don't need to be having sideline friends either then. I need all your friends.
So that's number six. What's number seven, Laverne?
There are specific places that he never wants to go. I mean, like...
The comedy show.
Right. Or a birthday party. I mean...
Jazz with a green.
Or he just avoiding those places for no good reason. He's avoiding them for no good reason, you know?
It is funny because as women, I shouldn't say this and I hope no one takes this personal, but this weekend, I saw the side chick and the main chick and the dude in one location. Boy, I wish I had me a bag of popcorn because I was waiting for them to collide. I was like, I wonder what's going to happen when they walk by. But he didn't know she was there. I wanted to say, hey, your side chick here. But you know you don't do that. But again, there's men do not take women. They whoever, they cheating, boy, they don't take you nowhere. They won't. You always be eating, having Red Box and Mike and Ike's.
Right.
Y'all have y'all favorite place that y'all go.
But you know what? But if you only, and then if they don't take you out in public and they want to always come to your house, you know, you can't even, they ain't even taking you to a dog fight, not even around the corner. That's when you know something. They don't even want to be seen with you. Now, that's when you know something.
Yeah, that's
when
you know something.
If a man can't be seen with you and take you out in public, then that means that he ain't thinking about you. And all you is going to be somebody he go cake up in the house with, because that's as far as it's going to go. Yep.
Okay, we gave y'all seven, but I got one more because this is like a real obvious sign, you know, and it wasn't there, you know, I didn't put it down. But what about if y'all not having sex? Is that a sign that a man is cheating?
I mean,
there's only 1 week out of the month you shouldn't be having sex with your man. Yeah. I'm sorry. 1 week and 2 days. That's 9 days out of the month. And as a woman, if you ain't doing that, then you better be helping out somewhere else, because them 9 days, that side chick is getting all you.
But what if you don't keep yourself up? What if you, like, just, you know, you're not attracted to your man? You know, he just not attracted to you. Did that mean just because y'all not having sex that, you know, he's cheating?
Well, if you coming in the bedroom with a nightgown on that look like it done been shot by a bullet, like you done been shot up.
With your hair bag on.
Right. Don't nobody want to see that. Now, see, me, personally, me, I sleep in like 90s in lingerie just for myself. I like to look at myself sometimes and be like, no, I like to really look nice when I go to bed. I mean, and so if I got a man, I'm really going to make sure, you know what I'm saying, that I'm looking on point, I'm smelling good. And then that's another thing. You got to go in there.
I take a bath every night before I go to bed, though. My husband could attest to that. Every night, I am not getting into bed dirty at all. Exactly. No way.
That's disgusting.
Yeah, I had, literally, the guy I used to date, it was so funny. He wanted to come up here and visit me. I was like, sure, you can come. And he was like, just promise me you won't smell good. I said, what do you mean? He was like, because when you get in the bed, he said, you always smell good. I said, I always take a shower. I said, I always put on perfume. But I don't care. I might have on some dang cotton shorts and a t-shirt.
I'm still smelling good. Right.
I mean, that's sexy.
Well, I do. Okay, see, I do half and half, because sometimes I ain't got time to get all dressed up and have on a nightie, and you know, I gotta wrap my hair up too. So sometimes I have on my tank top with my boxer shorts on or something, you know, I have on my Victoria's Secret long nightgown or something, but I gotta have on something, you know, that's decent.
No, bullet,
No.
I ain't walking around with an old t-shirt from,
and then sometimes I got on my Yves Saint Laurent nightgown or whatnot, you know, that's my favorite nightgown.
But you just, you know, you gotta look sexy. You know, I like to personally look sexy. I like to do different things, you know, when I have a husband, not, you know, just
sometimes you gotta go to bed in heels, you know.
I don't like
hardly get up in the bed now.
I get in the bed with them on, but that don't mean I'm going to sleep in them. I ain't going to wake up in them, you know what I'm saying? But I get in the bed with them on.
I'm like, oh, Jesus.
You got to keep it interesting, though.
Yeah, you do. You do have to keep it interesting.
You got to keep it different. You got to, you know, do different things.
Oh. I am really about to learn this dance, but I don't know when I'm gonna do it. But well, we can't be.
You know what? One of our topics.
I'm gonna learn the little Sierra, the little body part.
Oh, okay.
I'm gonna be all over the place.
We should go do a pole dancing class.
Girl, I ain't getting up on no pole.
But you know what? We gotta save this for next week because this is next week's topic: how to spice up your sex life and keep your man happy. So we can't, you know, we can't give him the ideas right now. We gotta give him some next week.
Sheree, look, you look really cute today.
Thank you.
If y'all can see, because some people, you know, some people watch us and then mm-hmm. some people just listen to us. So if you mm-hmm. can see her today, like she looks like a ghetto, like one of those video chicks, you know what I'm saying? She got her little rope chain on. She look real cute.
Thank you. See, and you know what? That's why I love you, though, because you give good props and I give you good props and you too.
Yeah.
We got to compliment each other. We definitely do.
She just ran from work.
Yeah.
But we do, you know, you as a woman, if mm-hmm. you see another woman that look nice, give them their props. Because I know I'll be looking good. And them girls that don't like me be like, but I know you ain't got to tell me.
Exactly.
But I'm just saying. You know what I'm saying? You need to let them know. Because
you got the best dresses I ever seen. I ain't even lying. Them dresses is bad.
But thank you. But, yeah, it's just like, you know, you need to give props and give credit where credit is due, really.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So, now, Precious, we missed you for, like, 20-30 minutes. We was like, okay, she'll be here in a couple of minutes, and then the time went by, so we kept on talking, and then here you come. So I'm so happy that you graced us with your presence
today.
Thank you so much. Love the fact that when we get your opinion and we all get together, it's just good.
I like doing this. I was a little teed off at my sister because she left my keys. I was heated. I will start walking. I said, I'm not about to walk down the street. Maybe I would calm down, but you know, I ran up out of work real quick to make sure I get here.
We happy you got here.
Yeah.
So is there anything that we don't?
What we gotta do? Like, we gotta do our 10 reasons why men cheat.
Oh yeah, run them down then. Okay, you can run them down.
10 reasons why men cheat. She lets herself go. Her sex life has died. They get bored because they can. It boosts ego. You grow apart, falling out of love. It's exciting, and sometimes men do get excited because something new for them.
Mm-hmm.
You allowed him to do it in the past, and then you cheated on him. And normally men do
retaliate.
It hurts a man more. It's different when a man cheats and when a woman, because we more accepting of it.
Mm-hmm.
But when a woman do it, that mean a man that will kill a relationship.
Yeah, it really will.
A man, because it's an ego thing. He feel like, you know, I know she ain't did that. I know she ain't gave up my stuff. You know mm-hmm. what I'm saying? So that's when it's a territorial thing.
Yes.
And that's the, you know, but, that'll kill a relationship.
Yeah, she let somebody get a cookie out the cookie jar.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, man.
Have we did purple haze thing yet?
No, we
haven't. Okay. No,
let me just say something real quick, guys. I just got to say this. Got to give a shout out to my babe. I turned 34 last Friday.
Right.
Happy birthday.
And let me tell you, at first it was really, I was really sad. I was kind of sad because, you know, I hit 34, and each year I go back and I read my journal, and it says it has certain things I should have done by the time I hit an age.
Mm-hmm.
And I didn't hit all the things I wanted to hit by 34.
Mm-hmm.
But I said, I still got this, you know, 33 was a rough year for me, but I said, okay, 34 is going to be a lot better. But I just want to give a shout out to my babe. You know who you are. I appreciate you because when I came home, I was just like, you know, kind of in a little funk. Didn't want to go to the concert. I didn't want to do nothing. But he got my favorite gift card from Von Mar. So I was pumped. And you know, you can't get, ain't nothing cheap in Von Mar. And I'm waiting to go out there. Because I'm like, okay, I want to go shopping. It's like, no, I don't want to go. And then we went and did massages and stuff. So we did. I was really excited and stuff. And then I didn't get to do Taste of Von Mar this weekend.
I did.
It was nice. It was very nice.
I had a really bad nice. Experience, though, on did you? Friday.
Yeah, I went on Friday, too.
No, I didn't go on Friday to Taste of Von Mar, but I went out.
Mm-hmm.
And I normally don't drink. And I drank a lot. to the point to where I threw up in my own car on Saturday morning.
That's a bad experience. That's,
I'm trying to pull over. I'm like,
did you go get that shampoo? Because that car gonna smell like that for
No, it don't smell like smell like chicken pot pie, but I gotta clean
that. Okay.
My sister and daughter,
you handled that.
They back it. I'm driving. They try to pat me on the back, but I couldn't pull over. And my sister was like, "What did you drink?" I was like, "Whatever it was." But I did go after I did that. Mm-hmm. I went to one of the little body wrap parties, and I did the little body wrap thing.
I did a body wrap too. I did one on Saturday. I don't know how many inches I lost, but my before and after pictures are amazing, ain't they, Shania? Yeah.
She did the before and after picture, and then she measured us after. And after I did it for an hour, I lost 2.5 inches. But
so,
here she go with that.
Okay, yeah, I did it. I need to stand up, too, because I did it. And I can see my results.
Listen, I got a question because I'm skeptical of this. Because if I go work out like I do, y'all know I go hard.
Mm-hmm.
If it take me, you know, a week or 2 weeks to lose some inches or somehow is you, they no, doing
they
this with
they measure.
I don't know. I got my pictures, though. You can look at my pictures.
I don't think I'm going to do it again. I think I'm about to really start doing some different stuff and working out because, you know, August 1st is coming and that's the white party. So, y'all know I got to be looking real.
See, I don't like to wear white. I don't like to wear white because then I look like a gallon of milk. I don't like to wear white.
It shows every dent. Mm-hmm. No. I've
never had a problem.
I'm going to tell you, if I wear white, I got to do like a white shirt with something black, a black blazer or something over it.
No.
And I can't wait. I ordered my dress, so I'll be trying that on. Then I found a white pantsuit that I've been really liking. So I'm going to order that one in 2 weeks because I don't know what I'm going to wear yet.
So when is the white party? I might attend.
August 1st.
We should attend, but let me
tell you. It's the cute white party. It's on holiday weekend.
I'm going to make sure that I'm going to go to Anna. If I'm going to do white, I need to camouflage some stuff because I don't like them dents and stuff.
Yeah, me either.
That looks horrible.
It does. But, I mean, we should all go and we should all just start really, I'm going to start running some more. And doing a little bit more.
I'm getting me another wrap this week. I ain't even lying.
I gotta get my membership and stuff together, you know, with me not working.
No, that ain't got nothing to do with. I can get you some
give me a free pass. I'll be up in that camp.
Yeah.
She was serious.
Ain't no
I don't shoot the table.
So
we gotta hit one topic, guys. And I think everybody in Omaha know, boy, Purple Haze went down last week.
Yes, it did.
Chief Smarter ain't no joke. He done shook the table on y'all. He didn't care. And if y'all think y'all getting away with some stuff in Omaha, Nebraska, y'all might as well can it up and pack it up and move it somewhere else because he is not playing.
Y'all better cancel Chris. Let me tell you one thing. I like him.
Hold on. Let's tell everybody what Purple Haze is, though, because a lot of people probably don't even know what Purple Haze is.
That's listening.
They know.
Purple Haze is where they took 10 kingpins. They called them kingpins, all of them, off the streets. 10 kingpins that sold drugs off the streets.
But I don't know if they've caught off. The last update that I saw on there, it was basically, my daughter has my phone. It basically said, you know, who was being brought down. I think it's a good thing. It involved La Vista Police, Ralston, Omaha, FBI. It had everybody because they failed to realize everybody keep thinking North Omaha. Nah, boo. They moving out to the burbs.
Right.
They out here running stuff out here. So, again, people, start checking. I'm sorry, and I'll let anybody know. Any dude that I've ever talked to, he knows I'm not your ride or die, your Bonnie and Clyde, your nothing. I'm not writing you. I'm not putting no money on your books. I'm not coming down there. I'm not even going to sit in the courtroom. You're going to be looking stupid by yourself. You, your mama, your baby mama, your cousins, your aunties, everybody else.
Preach.
Anyways, next thing. Kudos to the police. They caught the young man that shot that young lady off at 35th and Reddit. I give much credit to everybody in the community who has actually been saying, who was giving tips. That young lady did not deserve to die as an honor student, a cheerleader at Benson. And I know her family is, they're still hurting because she's not here, but I know they have some sense of relief knowing that that person is no longer walking the streets. So again, big up to the police department. You know, you still need to work on some things, but you're trying.
That chief's my, let me tell you, from day one, when that man came into office, I like him.
Yep.
He, you know, he didn't run from no situation. When it came down to them police officers, right is right and wrong is wrong. And he seen that the police officer was wrong, and he handled that business, and he stuck to his guns.
Yep.
He came to them 360 meetings, and that man got up there, and he talked to all of us, and he said he's going to make the right decision. He answered questions. Mm-hmm. He did. He handled his business.
And he said, give him time, and he said it was mm-hmm. not, he was not going to
pull it to the side. Right.
And I asked him, I remember asking him, how was he going to discipline, you know, the people in the police officers that he called his friends, you know, how is he going to handle them when they get out of control? He said, you know what? I ain't got no friends. He said, I'm solo. I roll solo dolo, basically, is what he said. I ain't got not one friend.
Let me stop.
So, I mean, and he doing his job.
He ain't married. He's single.
Well, I'm going to give y'all next week's topics before we get out of here. One of our topics is going to be ways to let your partner know that you want sex, because, you know, that can be uncomfortable sometimes. How to keep your man happy and how to keep y'all sex life exciting. And 10 ugly mistakes women make that ruins any chances of having a good relationship.
Oh, that's what's up. We're going to have some good. Everybody make sure. Oh, this week we're going to have our Facebook page. For our show, I'm gonna get that together.
Yes.
So you guys can start putting questions on there. Also, remember the Juneteenth parade is this Saturday. 30th Street. Also, they're gonna have Juneteenth in the Village, just like they had Christmas in the Village. Make sure you come out and support. That's gonna be after the parade. There's some other things at. I'm not for sure, but if you need to look up, you know, get the Revive magazine, because it has all the list of all the Juneteenth stuff in there. I've been trying to read everything, trying to see what's going on in the city. Also, I heard another club has closed down recently. Alter Eagle is now closed, from what I heard. They went, it's a wrap, after they charged $25 a bottle for somebody's Barefoot Moscato. You should have been closed. I don't care. Charge it to the game. So much stuff going on this weekend. Bring your family out. Support North Omaha. Everybody be safe. What else you got to say?
And that's all. Oh,
well, I want to give a shout out for Tila Mickles. She is putting on a performance for the piece. It's going to be Friday, June 28th. It's going to be from 6:30 to 9 p.m. It's going to be at the Croc Center, and she's with Compassion in Action.
Okay.
So y'all save that date, Friday, June 28th. The cost is going to be $12 per ticket, and then you can also get group rates for $10. We will be in the building.
Okay. Make sure you support this organization. Miss Tila and all the people that are behind her are really, really, really working hard. I know they did the blues thing, the lady sings the blues thing.
Oh, that was so fun.
And we got to support these other nonprofits, because if we don't support them, who's going to help our children? Because we can't all do it together. It takes a village, and we need to start supporting each other. And even if it's going in for 10, 15 minutes, look, you spend $12 at Catfish Corner, you can spend $12 on Compassion in Action. Miss Precious is done for the day. I don't say my piece.
Well, we got to give some love to 1690 AM, the one, home of the voiceless. We love y'all, and I love y'all. Uh-huh.
Can I ask you a question, William? How did you guys do for the
Made like $450 from Omaha Gift.
Omaha
Gift.
That's
good. Better than nothing.
But they did they match it though?
Yeah, I think so.
Okay, so again, we got
$900. Okay,
yeah,
good.
That's okay.
So we can get out there. I mean, a lot of things is happening in the city, and I think, you know, everybody's being positive, and we got to support each other, because that's the only way we're gonna really let Omaha grow. So
we got another show coming up.
Okay,
okay,
gotta go.
Well, we about to get up out of here.
And that's my fault.
We out.
Yep.
Y'all keep
Avenue got me up to the